Hello everyone, good afternoon. Today I want us to examine the answers to the just concluded 2023 English language examination. And we shall be starting with paper one. And the first section in that paper covers question one to question 10. That is antonyms. Look for a word that is what? Nearly opposite in meaning to the underlined. The posh cars were sandwiched between two dash ones. Antony. A-N-T signifies antony. A. Dented. B. Rugged. C. Rickety. D. Modest. The correct answer to this question is C, which is rickety. The word posh means glamorous, beautiful, elegant. Okay, so posh car here means beautiful car, elegant car, okay? Well-built car, flashy car, if you like. So, the word modest is very close in meaning to posh, so we cannot consider modest. And then you come to option B, rugged. Rugged is still very close to posh here, because if a car is a posh car, then it's very likely that it's a rugged car, okay? That is, it's well-built. So, we cannot consider B. Then what about dented car? You can have a rugged car or a well-built car as a posh car that is dented. Dented means it has had an impact or be hit, okay? So, we cannot consider dented as well. The correct answer, therefore, is rickety. Question two. A trivial issue often becomes that when it is not properly handled. Antony, that is nearly opposite in meaning to trivial. A, valuable. B, serious. D, unbearable. D, ordinary. The correct answer to this question is unbearable. Now, trivial, what's the meaning of trivial? It means something that is flimsy or that is not what? Too strong or too important. If you look at valuable, this means something that's expensive or costly. So we cannot say that an issue is expensive or costly. No. Then what about a word like ordinary? This word cannot apply. It looks very ordinary in this expression. The word itself is ordinary. So you can be left with B and C. Serious. Many students might be tempted to consider serious. A trivial issue often becomes serious. It looks like an ordinary expression. It looks too casual to say the issue will become serious. No. Rather, you say the issue will become unbearable. So the correct answer is C. Question three. The rock star's stellar performance contrasted sharply with the dull showing of the amateur group. A. Routine. B. Woeful. C. Mundane. D, awkward. Remember, we are considering antonym. That's A-N-T, a word that's nearly opposite in meaning to stellar. There are two themes in this question, that is, or two sides to the question. Here we have rock star side and amateur group side. A group can be tagged amateur if it is inexperienced. So, stellar here means the attribute of a star that is shining. In other words, you can replace that with shiny and say, shiny performance, the rock star's shiny performance. Then what I'm going to attach to the performance of the amateur group? Is it going to be routine, woeful, mundane, or awkward? Some persons might think of woeful, which is not bad in itself. What about mundane? Mundane is irrelevant here because mundane means something carnal or worldly, material thing. So it's really not applicable to this question. But you have options like routine performance, woeful, and awkward performance. Some persons might be quick to think of B and D, but no. Yes, amateur groups' performance can be tagged woeful or awkward. But from the way the question is set, that is, contrasted sharply with the that showing. This word showing here means the type of performance that the amateur group is giving us here is peculiar to them, that is, they are used to it. So it cannot be woeful showing or awkward showing, but routine showing. So the correct answer is routine showing. That it has become a normal thing about the amateur group. That the type of performance that they are giving here is a usual performance. That they are used to it. That's why the word showing here is what's implied. Contrasted sharply with the routine showing. Question 4. Tolu was sanctioned for late coming, but his friend was dashed. A. Pardoned. B. Ignored. C. Exempted. D. Released. Remember, we are considering AMT, which is Anthony. Alright, so these are two persons again in this question. Tolu and what? His friend. Now, one was sanctioned, whereas the other was not. So if someone is not sanctioned, then I'm going to say that the person is pardoned, the person is ignored. You cannot say the person is ignored. Are we going to say the person is exempted? Yes, you can consider this. What about, we're going to say the person is what, released? No, the word released does not apply here. It's only when someone has been arrested that can talk about being released. Now we are left with option A and C. That is the word pardoned and exempted. I'm not considered pardoned or exempted. The correct answer is pardoned. Because Tolu and his friends, okay, have already got into the issue. Alright, they have already got into this trouble. So, since they have already got into the trouble, then the one that is not going to be penalized or that's not going to be sanctioned or punished would have to be pardoned and not exempted. Question 5. While other teachers' support for the action was dash, Victor's was dogged. A. Declining. B. Woeful. C. Disappointing. D. Wavering. Remember, we're considering Anthony, A-N-T. Okay, and the word we are looking at now is what? Dogged. That is, to choose an option that is what nearly opposite to dogged. The correct answer here is D, wavering. Now, look at it very closely. If you say something is dogged, you mean it is strong, it is stiff, it is unwavering. So, a word that's going to be opposite to dogged here is wavering. Number 6. Some people are good at terminating other people's project, but are not capable of dash theirs. A. Initiating theirs. B. Organizing theirs. C. Executing theirs. D. Designing theirs. Remember, we are considering Anthony. So a word that is nearly opposite to the word terminating here as it applies to project is executing theirs. Because when you terminate a project, then you are not able to execute it or to finish it. So the word that is opposite meaning to it is what? Executing. Question 7. The precarious terraces of the stadium have been transformed into a dash walkway. A. Durable. B. Secure. C. Smooth. D. Narrow. You're looking for a word that is opposite in meaning to precarious. Now, what's the meaning of precarious? Precarious is something that is loose and not well fixed. In other words, something that is not secure. So the correct answer is secure. Question 8. If one thing irritates you, it might dash another. A. Delight. B. Concern. C. Invigorate. D. Bother. Looking for a word that is opposite in meaning to irritate. And the word is delight. So if something irritates you, that is, it is disgusting to you, or you are disgusted about it. The opposite of that would be to be delighted about it. So delight is the word. Question 9. Jay was loud as a teenager, but dash as an adult. A. Peaceful. B. Reserved. C. Humble. D. Respectful. And we're looking for a word that is opposite in meaning to loud. And take note that the way loud is used in this expression is figurative. It doesn't mean that Jane sounds like some kind of audiovisuals, but that Jane was extroverted as a teenager. And the opposite of being extroverted is to be reserved. So B is the correct option. Question 10. Do not always reprimand your children. It is good to dash them at times. What's the meaning of the word reprimand? Reprimand means to criticize or to launch verbal attack on some persons. Okay, so the opposite of reprimanding people is to compliment them. So if you do not criticize people, you praise them. So the word, the opposite word is compliment. So that's that on question 1 to 10, as captured in section A of the 2023 WAEC English Paper 1.